Hey, gang, welcome to the Are You Garbage Comedy Podcast.
Please make sure you subscribe. That way you get the episodes as they come out.
Welcome to another exciting edition of Are You Garbage? The show where you find out if your favorite comedians are classy individuals or absolute trash. Now, here are your hosts, Kevin Ryan and H. Foley.
Hey, everybody out there, and welcome back to everybody's favorite new podcast. This is Are You Garbage? It's a show where we sit down with your favorite comedians, and we find if they grew up classy or if they're absolute trash. Mm-hmm. I'm your host, H. Foley, coming at you on a beautiful day. We're down here at Aunt Tootie's basement. She just made a Wawa run, and I know she's on her way back because I just got a Venmo request for $2.25 for a pack of crimpets.
Oh, boy.
My co-host is coming at you from right next to me. That's all we had on that one this week.
Light news and Tootie, huh? Okay.
He is the CEO of Are You Garbage. He put the whole thing together. He's the mastermind, ladies and gentlemen. Give it up for Kevin James Ryan.
Hey, gang. Thanks for tuning in. As always, please make sure you rate, review, subscribe on iTunes. Full video available on YouTube. And as you know, those numbers are
true to roof.
True to fucking roof. And then Patreon.com, you can sign up. You can get bonus episodes of AYG. You can get episodes of Hard Feelings, which are just me and Foley fucking shooting the shit. Him calling me bald, me calling him fat. It's a good fucking time.
Oh, yeah.
The breakaway hit of 2021, by the way.
Everybody loves it.
And then we'll play with our top tier patrons. We play AYG with you guys once or twice a month. You ask us questions. We ask you questions. And then, in even bigger news.
Oh, tell them. Tell them.
We're hitting the road, Jack.
Hitting the fucking road. April 20th, Raleigh Goodnights down here in North Carolina. April 21st, Zany's Nashville. Get your fucking tickets now. It's going to sell out. I'm telling you.
Yeah, guys, Chicago, we just got word. Chicago's almost sold out. Woo! So Chicago's in June. Get those tickets now. Also, Indy is moving as well. All the tickets are moving, baby. The boys are hitting the road. Check it out.
Link, we got the link tree up.
Links in the description. Check it out.
There we go. And, of course, speaking of Chicago, shout out to the pride of Chicago comedy scene. He is two golden brown English muffins, a slice of American cheese, and a big old sauce each. Give it up for T-Bone McMuffin, Toby McMullen, everybody.
What up,
kid's got
dudes?
A big piece.
Kid's got a big piece and needs a haircut, by the way. This kid's got a mop top on him.
And all those tickets we sold in Chicago are people who I owe money. So that's going to be an awkward show.
Hey, I'm looking for Toby over there. I said he was going to be on a show. But, gang, that's neither here nor there. We could not be more excited to have our incredibly, incredibly special guest back with us again today. Mm-hmm. It's a family episode. We got some company. We got some real company. We actually cleaned the place up a little bit.
I took out the trash before we got here.
Took out the trash.
I did.
As OG as it gets, you know him, you love him. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Mr. Robert Kelly.
Yeah.
It fucking annoys me to no end the fucking just synergy you two fucking assholes.
What do you
have.
Mean?
I mean, that was flawless. That was like a fucking, if I was going to do a movie and have guys, hey, give it up for fucking, they're cling, 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 and a batch, and mama's mom's coming back, and come see you, and don't forget Big Tick Toby, I owe money, woo. All right, let's give, I mean, that was flawless.
The kids got chemistry, baby.
I mean, not one fucking misstep, bing, bang. There was one point where you were talking, there was a little gap, and he jumped in, sabababoo, fucking, I mean, what
I
the?
I knew we were pissing him off with that long intro.
It was the fucking polishness of you guys are fucking, I mean,
we're
crazy.
Cooking over here.
We're
baby.
Not some bums they found in the village. What do you mean? We've been doing this for a while.
Yeah, a year. A fucking year. I've been doing it for 15. I was the first one to have a podcast on the East Coast. I still flubble when I, hey guys, dude, oh, yeah, and I fucking mush mouth I am. You two cocksuckers, it's a magic. Even Toby was he was great.
He's usually good for a flub in the intro.
Wow.
And we got in here at noon and started practicing.
Yeah. I mean, that was fucking, whoa. Now, does he got a big dick?
He's got a big piece. Uncut big hog on him.
I'm going to say this.
Unconfirmed.
I always thought that.
I'll find out in Raleigh.
I just tasted pickles.
Pickles? Wow.
I don't know why. That fucking thought of you fucking sneaking into his room and fucking pulling his tidy whities down because you know he wears tidy whities. Yeah.
Absolutely not.
He's a sheath guy, I hear. Sheath.com, everybody.
That is the most fiendish shit I've ever seen. He just fucking went, ah. I love Toby. This is great.
We're having fun, folks.
What's up, guys?
Buddy, we're happy to have you. I like that he just keeps getting better and better. He looks amazing.
You look
like time traveler, Bobby.
Dude, your skin is fantastic.
Yeah.
I have the skin of a Filipino boy. I'm 50. I look amazing.
Dude. And the butthole. You look better now than you did in the prior year. I'm not shitting on you. You look fantastic.
Bit. I mean, it's a little bit. You said I look like shit then.
No. You look so good now.
I have great skin, dude.
Wow.
I don't know what it is.
The whole look. The jacket, the glasses.
The glasses are nice. You should have got the big ones.
I got the watch. Yeah, well,
doesn't he look like from the future with this guy?
It looks like that guy from the Ocean's movies.
Bobby 91223.
I don't know his name.
It sucks that you couldn't get his name. That would have been fucking great.
The guy from the Ocean's 11 movies.
Now he just murdered him again.
You got Toby, IMDb him. Put it in post.
That sucks when you got a good one. You're like, the guy from the thing with the thing.
I knew I wasn't going to get it out, and I knew you were going to call me out.
You're talking about Elliot Gould.
Yes.
From the plane.
Yes. Or you could have went
You gotta
Mo
be
Green.
Crazy to rob a casino.
Yeah,
Mo Green.
Yeah.
I was banging cheerleaders two at a time.
That's
right?
Not the quote, but okay.
Yeah, whatever. 17, I don't find. I'm not one of those. I hate fucking stat people and quote people.
Stat people can hit the fucking bricks.
I had that one time. Who was it? Jay Moore walked up to me. Hey, were you a Red Sox fan? Yeah, I love the Red Sox. I'm from Boston. Yeah, who's your center fielder? I don't give a fuck.
I hate that shit,
I don't give a fuck.
I hate that.
The guy with the guy that looks fucking Spanish and white.
Yeah, I hate that too, man. If like you don't know enough about the team, then you're not a true fan. Yes. I don't know who the fuck played
outside linebacker
for the
watch.
Eagles in 78, but... You know, I still enjoy the squad.
Yes, I do. I love a team. I love the Pats. I love all. Why is it that we have to love? It's very culty that you have to love your teams from your town.
I kind of like it though. I don't like when people like other teams from other towns.
But when America does something like the Olympics,
sure.
We all fucking
beat them. Yeah. Fuck, it's us versus them, baby.
Got to beat those Chinese. Come on.
I don't know if that's going to happen anymore.
Yeah, I think they got our number moving forward.
Yeah, they just bought Africa. I think they just
signed the deal.
They own a lot of shit. They own the shit you're doing this on, they own.
Oh, yeah.
Pull our plug right now.
Oh, they'll show. We shut down all podcasts.
The lights just go out.
Oh, my God. Bobby, thank you for coming back. Folks, if you haven't seen Bobby's episode, please go back and check it out. It's absolutely fucking amazing. Real Boston trash.
Yeah.
Right?
Now, that's the thing I was wondering. Was I trash?
You weren't. Yeah. Classy. I know that.
You have to say it. Like
you didn't win the caviar award.
Do you have caviar award?
No.
Oh, dude, if you don't do an award show
that's
at the end of
good.
Your fucking year, you're an asshole.
That's pretty good.
If you don't have caviar
the
award.
The caviar award? And that's pretty good. Did you just come up with that?
I did.
I got to give you a raise.
It. I came up with
no,
it.
No, I think he did.
He said caviar award. I said make it a show, award show.
All right, I want to get an executive producer credit. Take it. This guy's all Hollywood.
I feel like I'm in a game of Hungry Hungry Hippos right now. Jesus Christ. I got these two chomping at me.
Let me tell you something. You get an award for most original fat joke. That was fucking great. You get a fucking Cinnabon award for that.
Extra sauce.
Oh, my God.
Ooh, frosting. There it is.
No,
all right.
You know what I was thinking about with Boston?
Food. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, what's for lunch? Now you got me all jacked up. I'm dying for some marbles.
What the fuck is a marble?
From the hungry hippos.
I'm a fat fuck. I'm thinking it's a pastry that I don't know about from Philly. I'm like,
he's like, I gotta get down there.
Dude, you gotta try marbles. Fucking Gladys is down on fucking South Street. Oh shit.
The thing about Boston is, so Philly's trash inside the city.
Yes.
Okay. I mean, there's some nice sections, but as far as like Boston proper,
it's a lot of money.
It's nice. So you really have to go to the whatever the fuck. Why is it
South
so many?
Shore, right?
Not anymore though.
What do you
mean? Okay, because when I was growing up, Boston proper, Newbury Street, all that shit, Comm Ave, it's all.
I'm talking like Beacon Hill, the North End, the Back Bay.
The North End was all Italian. It was the fucking mob, so it was nice because they take care of their neighborhoods.
Yeah, sure.
But right around it was
real quick. Just I want to tell you, I had a lobster roll at in the North End a couple years ago at this place on whatever that main strip is.
Yeah.
It's fucking unbelievable.
Yeah, North End is this is why I love unbelievable. The North End. It's fucking, they did not let anybody take it over. It's still
a lobster claw. What's it called?
It's still fucking all Italian people over there.
Yeah, it's
I
nice.
Mean, they let people sneak in here and there,
yeah.
but it's still all
tight ship. They
it's
run a
what
tight
it
ship.
Was when I left.
Yeah, it's nice.
Except better. But around Boston, South Boston, Charlestown, Somerville, all that was, you'd fucking, I got mugged when I was 8 in Charlestown.
Really?
Yeah, the guy took 85 cents.
Big week for him.
I was going to the mall with me and my friend, 85 cents.
What were you
going to
get?
I was just going to the mall. That's what you did back then. Yeah, you know what I mean?
You just went to the mall. Yeah. That was the thing. You just went to the mall.
You went to the park or the mall. Yeah. That's it. You walked around the mall. Mm-hmm. You maybe fucking tried to squeeze an Orange Julius out of somebody. And you sat at the fountain and tried to fucking, you know, look at some albums that are coming out. But he took it. I remember, can I get 10 cents back to call my mom? And he threw me 10 cents. And I called my mom. I go, you can come pick me up. She's like, where are you? I go, I just got mugged at the Somerville, Charlestown area. And she was like, yeah, take a bus home. I go, I got mugged. Yeah. I had to walk home. So, but now, Bobby. It's Jesus. Fucking Charlestown. You can't. It's
nice.
All rich.
Really?
Southie, all rich.
All the toonies.
Somerville. Yeah, dude, it's all that.
I've stayed in Somerville. Somerville, where I stayed, was nice. Like,
it's all when yeah, I was yeah. growing up. I can't tell you how many times I got the shit kicked out. I mean, shit for nothing other than coming from Medford.
Really?
Like they'd be like, "Where are you from, Medford?" And I would wake up
mm-hmm.
like 20 minutes later.
That's such a dirtbag city thing. Like neighborhoods. Oh, it's the neighborhoods. Like I hear, I go home to, I bet these, we'll be at the bar, like drinking with my knucklehead cousins, and they'll look over and see like a group of kids making noise. Like, I bet the Mayfair kids. You know what I mean? I bet the Kenzie, like, it's all.
You're all bozos.
Yeah, you're all dirtballs.
You're all sitting at the same shitty bar.
We had parks when I was growing up. So you had a park.
That was your, whatever was your turf.
Yeah, like the,
oh, that was your turf?
The Italians with Tufts Park.
What is this, the 50s? It's like Greece with bad music.
Yeah, I'm from Somerville.
It was the 80s. So the Irish kid had North Park, Car Park. The black kids had Duggar Park. And then there was the mix that was at Placedead Park.
Mm-hmm.
And the parks used to fight each other.
That's crazy.
So the parks used to fight each other, and the park I hung out with was all the Italian kids. They were fucking maniacs. But some of it was right next door. So we would always bop over to their park and fight them. And I remember once, and I hated it. I hated it so bad because I just like to have fun,
mm-hmm.
you know? And we went over there one day, and we saw these three kids from Somerville in this little parking lot behind these stores. And my friends, I'm like, here we go. Fucking fight. They had a
How old
box.
Are we talking?
I had to be 13.
Okay.
So we walked in. All my friends are 18, though. 17, 18. Fucking animals. I mean, violent people I hung out with. And but they were like, hey, you playing wiffle ball? Let us play. So all of a sudden, we all start playing together. And we were all, there was like three kids with us and three kids with them and kind of the same age. So the kid my age, they were like, hey, you two go get drinks or something at the store. So we're like, all right. So me and this kid went from somewhere. We went and got drinks. We got mm-hmm. snacks. So we're coming. We're talking. We're laughing. We're having, like, me and this kid hit it off.
Yeah.
Like, I was
You're
like,
planning a trip to the mall next week.
I did. I love this kid. And we're walking back with snacks. We're eating, like, fucking Susie Q's. We got some drink. And we walk back, and I just see the kid's radio flying in the flying in the air, and it just fucking boom hits the kid right on the head. And I'm like, eh.
Here we
and
go.
We just dropped the shit. We just started fighting each other.
That's like when the two goalies in a hockey, they have no animosity.
Yes.
But they're like, well, fuck, my team's rolling. I got to go.
I was so sad. I was like,
started out with a nice day, some fuck. Wiffle ball, some Susie Q's.
I really liked you, Sean, but here we go.
Bobby's got 15 cents and a length of chain.
You'd fight, the parks would fight each other.
Parks would, yeah.
That's a thing, too, where you can sense the fight coming. You're like, this is...
Yeah, well,
we're like, I was somewhere like hanging out with comics who aren't fighters, but I was also hanging out with my dirtbag friends.
Right.
Like, and we were at a bar, and I looked at I could just sense it. Like, I'm like, you guys, I told the comic, like, you guys got to get the fuck out of here because shit's going to go south quick.
Oh, I could sense it.
And then 2 seconds
the
after they left, it just like fucking broke out.
I hung out, the kids out at my park, I think the older kid was like 35. And,
what?
Oh, dude, he was.
What was in this park? Are you guys really like swing sets?
It was
What's
a
going on?
Yeah.
The fuck?
Nice merry-go-round.
It was a park during the day, and then at night we took it over, and that's where we drank and did drugs and fucking fought people.
Cops didn't fuck with you?
Cops did fuck with us, but we would fuck with them. So, you know, we'd have to switch sides of the park. You know what I mean? They would come down all the time and fuck with us. I remember I was in trouble, and I was with the older kids who were like fucking crazy. Mikey Catalano, Lonnie Hilson. These guys are
those
fucking
are great names, by the way. Oh, Mikey Catalano will tune you up.
Jake Gags, Joey Gags.
Any Gags.
I mean,
is
dude,
great.
These guys.
No doctors in the bunch.
a lot of pipe fitters.
Are you Dr. Joey Gags? Yeah.
Yeah, they were all fucking
85
tough.
Cents, get on the table.
Yeah, Mikey O.
Love the names.
They were so tough. And they would, I remember one night my three uncles were their age too. They came down looking for me. And I was like over here. I felt so bad because my uncles came down. Where's Bobby? They were like, who are you? Like, where are his uncles? Yeah, he's doing all right. Why don't you take off? He'll be home a little later.
Jesus Christ.
And they were like, all right.
Oh, no. I saw your uncles bitch up?
Well, listen, dude. They were like, come home. I was like, yeah, I'll be home a little while. I was a fucking piece of shit. Back then, piece of shit.
Yeah?
Yeah, garbage.
Because you're so sweet
bad
now.
Kid.
Oh, bad kid back then. But I didn't want to be
bad. You weren't mugging
bad.
People.
I did.
You did?
Later in life, yeah. I took a moped.
I feel. Hey, we've all been on vacation.
Yeah, I mean, that's harmless fun right there.
A moped.
Poor kid. I remember I took
it's not even a felony, I don't think. What's a moped set you back? A couple of bucks.
A moped.
Hey, watch out, this guy
then.
Steals Vespas. Keep an eye on him.
True. Not mopeds back there were hard to come by.
I'm talking about a moped when mopeds came out.
Damn.
You know what I mean? There was that
it's
kid.
Like stealing a Bugatti.
Yeah, exactly. This kid got a moped and we were like, this fuck. Mm-hmm. Him and his and I we took it for a day. We weren't assholes. We'd give it back. We'd just leave it on your street somewhere.
Sure.
But I mean, years later, I got sober. I'm my life is going great. I went back to high school. I graduated. I got a scholarship to a Bunker Hill Community College for art. I'm in English class, and my life is going great. And all of a sudden, we're going around the room, and they're like, hey, I'm blah, 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 blah. And I looked at the kid next to me. I go, hey, I'm Robert. He goes, I know who you are. And I went, oh, shit. It was a kid I took the moped from. He was in my English class, and he was still mad.
Yeah, I'd be fucking pissed, too. Stole a kid's wheels.
Yeah, we got it back. He got it back. It was a little dented up. Fuck him.
I know who you are.
Could have sold it.
I know who you are. He's got a picture of you at his house.
I apologize. We made up. We're good.
Man, I had a moped growing up. Pretty sweet ride.
Mopeds are great.
Yeah.
I don't care what they say. Mopeds are fucking great.
Good time.
Yeah, it's a fantastic
time. I had a go-kart, too.
What do you do as far as... with Max, would you let Max get a go-kart or a moped or anything like that?
You know, that's funny.
In the future. He's still pretty young, right? What is he?
I would. I just got him a Segway, like a legitimate Segway with the
with
big
the
wheels. Well, it's in your legs. It comes up in between your legs.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
I've
but it's
those.
It's big wheels. It's not the little ones.
Not the
little shit ones people are dying on that'll light on fire. It's from Segway. It's like big wheels. Mm-hmm. And the only reason why I got it, we were at somebody's house who had it. And he jumped on it and just started flying around. I'm like, fuck it. Kid's got it.
How old is he now?
He's going on eight. Going on eight right now. But yeah, I'd get him a moped. Fuck yeah.
What about like a mini bike to ride around in the backyard?
We went up to Maine, right? And I'm sitting there talking to these people because we're trying to get this tiny home, right?
Love a tiny home.
Love a fucking tiny
home. My wife wants one so bad.
Dude, tiny homes of Maine.
I know, I've been on this. Yes, I'm well aware.
You gotta talk to those people. They make the best. Anyways,
a tiny home,
something you can't fit in.
Yeah. No,
every house.
I don't
want to
be rude, but what are you doing, Bobby?
They customize it.
He's got wide doorways.
Yeah,
it's like a shed. It's like a nice shed.
A shed?
No, it's not. It's a home. It's a fucking home. Toilet, kitchen, everything.
And the thing is, if it's under a certain square foot in a lot of places, you don't have to pay real estate tax on
exactly.
it.
Exactly. Yeah. And they're fucking. I mean, it's great.
They're cool looking too.
We went up there to get. You know, we're way up to Maine. They're on like near the Canadian border. And we're sitting down in the home. We're talking to this couple. They're the best couple ever. And young couple. And I'm talking to them. I'm trying to give my, fire. Well, I let Max do what he, I don't want him to be afraid. I let him do what he wants to do and, let him, venture out and be venturous and stuff like that. And I look and Max, who's seven at the fucking time, is on a ATV by himself, flies by the window. And I went, Max is on there. He goes, I thought you wanted him to be fearless.
That's great.
And I was just like, yeah, okay. And I just had to eat my words and let the kid fucking zip around an apple orchard on a fucking ATV.
I meant like watch horror movies.
PG-13, maybe.
I meant go on a roof, maybe go down a mountain on a sled. I don't. The fuck you
go
talking
on a roof.
Stay up till 11.
Yeah. That's such a city guy fear. Maybe put a kid on a roof. I don't know.
Do you remember? I used to go on roofs all the
time.
Dude,
that's what I wanted to ask you. Like, because you were wild at a young age. I mean, I was pretty bananas. I look back, like, I wouldn't want a 20-year-old doing the shit that we used to do.
No way.
Dude, roofs. I mean, we just, like, light fire. We just did crazy shit all the time.
Oh, on the train tracks. We would fuck around with train. Like, we would fuck around with trains.
This is, it's a little different. You're talking about the suburbs in the early 90s.
80s.
No, for him. Oh, yeah. It was the 90s. Him, early 80s in the city in Boston. Stabbing people.
I know. I'm not saying. I'm just saying the shit you used to do compared to the shit I'm going to let my kid
we
do.
We didn't fucking stab anybody, okay?
Yeah. Listen. Yeah, you threw a couple eggs at the mailman. This guy was living Grease 3 over here.
You were eating Tasty Cakes. So
I didn't say so that I wasn't.
I'm just saying the shit. We rode quads. We jumped off bridges.
Jumped
fucking,
off a bridge.
We, that's what I'm saying. We were on roofs. We used to just go fucking construction sites. We tried stealing their backhoe. Well, we did everything.
He was race rioting. What are you
talking
about?
I know. I'm not saying.
Not in Boston. We didn't have to deal with that. We were
I'm
over
trying
here
to act like Goodwill Hunting over here. I'm Boston, just fucking saying. Boston I rode a quad once.
Boston was very segregated back then. I remember one time, me and Chris Bracha, who was my best friend at the time, we got, you know, the pallets.
Sure.
Okay, they have a pallet, but they used to make styrofoam ones for Pepsi.
Yeah.
Okay, it was a styrofoam big pallet. We got one of those and put it in the Mystic River, and we took that.
What the fuck's the Mystic? There's a real river called the Mystic River?
There's a Mystic River in Meffitt that goes all the way into Galway.
Didn't know that?
Sounds like Narnia. What the Mystic River?
Sean Penn, Mystic River.
Exactly. Oh, that
Kevin
river.
Bacon.
Casey Affleck.
We got in that and took it all the way out into the almost the ocean.
Jesus.
We were little kids. Yeah.
You don't know any better.
We got sticks and we got this little boat and we were just in it. And I remember this
Jesus
boat.
I like how you called
Christ.
It a boat. It's a piece of styrofoam. Yeah, we got a boat, Ma. He paints the name on the side.
I got a sail.
The SS Tiny Home or something.
Bobby's crabbing over there in the harbor. He's got a new boat. He's taking the whole family out this weekend. He's doing good.
Man, yeah. Stay out of those crab pots. You know that's Bill's livelihood.
I caught you some Susie Q's, Ma. Hold on a second there, gang. Let's real quick talk about our favorite sponsor here on the podcast, Sheath Underwear. Ladies and gentlemen, fantastic product. Keeps everything nice and cozy and in its place.
Yeah, guys. If you're not familiar, it's a two-pouch system they got going. They got a pouch for your balls, a pouch for your wee-wee. You can put your wee-wee in one pouch, the other pouch. It doesn't mean go no pouch, one pouch, two pouch. Whatever you want, baby, you can do. Keeps your boys all nice and in the right place. It's also the most comfortable. Minus that, the fabric is fantastic. It's breathable. It's modal, spandex. It's the whole thing. They got cool. You feel sexy in them, I got to say.
They're great.
I feel like an underwear model. I feel like I should be along in the box of one of these things.
They're great. Invented and owned by an Iraqi war veteran.
Yeah. Who's the go-to guy. I email with him. He's a hands-on fucking guy. He loves comedy podcasts. Mm-hmm. He supports a lot of comedy podcasts, and he fucking loves the show. So support them, guys. Go to sheathunderwear.com. Use promo code GARBAGE for 20% off your next purchase. It's fantastic. Give it a shot. What's the worst that can happen? You feel good? That's it, baby.
It will be the best pair of underwear you ever put on.
100%.
Guarantee it.
Guys, sheathunderwear.com. Use promo code GARBAGE.
Let's face it, gang. Taking trips to the post office is no fun way to spend your time. That's why we have a solution for you with our sponsor here on the show, Stamps.com. We are recommending Stamps.com to everybody. It allows you to mail and ship anytime, anywhere, right from your computer. You can send letters. You can send packages. And you pay a lot less with discount rates from USPS and UPS and more.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy. Stamps.com has saved businesses thousands of hours, Ooh. And tons of money. With Stamps.com, you get the service of the post office and UPS all in one place. Not to mention,
what's that?
You got big discounts on mailing and shipping rates.
Yeah, guys, it's a fantastic product service. We use it. We use it to send out our merch. Mm-hmm. If you're a small business owner, you can use it to send out invoices. You can send out products. Whatever you need to do, you need a printer, you need some Wi-Fi and a computer. I don't care if you work from your house, if you work from an office, if you're in the basement of Aunt Tootie's, if you're in your new Kia Forte, whatever you're in, go to Stamps.com and get involved. Stamps.com is a no-brainer, saves you time and money. No wonder there's over a million small businesses that use Stamps.com. So stop wasting time by going to the post office and use Stamps.com. Mm-hmm. There's no risk. Use our promo code GARBAGE. When you get there, for a special offer that includes a 4-week trial plus free postage and a digital scale. And, buddy, no long-term commitment at all.
Fantastic.
Just go to stamps.com, click on the microphone at the top of the homepage, and type in our code GARBAGE at stamps.com. Never go to the post office again.
Mm. Finally, gang, real quick, we want to talk to you about the good time Uncle Hank and Aunt Kippy are having over there on the Stereo app, usually every Thursdays at 9 o'clock. We're chopping it up, and we're taking your questions.
Yeah, guys, it's a super cool app. It's like a live stream. You get to ask us your garbage questions. You get to record them live. We play them live. We answer it. I have a couple of beers. It's a fun time. It's like a little bit of an after party. So
it's nice.
Use the link in the description, www.stereo.com/KevinRyan or /H Foley.
Sure.
We get to wet our beaks a little bit. Sign up. It's a good time. We'll see you there.
Peace. Back to the show. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, back
out into the ocean.
Dude, we almost went to the ocean. This boat drove by and went, you
the
kids,
fuck are you doing?
You kids need help. And I remember they towed us back. They didn't even let us get in their boat. They threw a rope out. We were just holding it, me and Chris, and water was coming up into the thing, and we were fucking getting scared. Dude,
Jesus.
We did a lot of shit. We used to climb the roofs of the churches. And
oh, yeah. We'd go on, like, school roofs and stuff.
Yeah,
it was fucking... You have nothing to do, especially in the suburbs, and there's no one around. You could just...
And your parents never were around.
I was the last generation, I think, that would, like, leave the house. I was born in 86, and I would leave the house in the summer
right.
for, like, you know, fucking 18 hours.
Hours.
And then just come back. And my mom would be like, call at 6 to check in.
Yeah.
Or call for whatever payphone or wherever house I was. I'd be like, hey, I'm here.
I wonder what, I mean, kids were getting fucking murdered and taken back then.
Oh, sure. Yeah, like crazy. Like, right? I was just thinking that, like, it's going to be tough for there to be, like, a real serial killer or, like, abduction ring going on now. Back in the 80s, 70s, 80s, that shit happened all the time.
But it happened all the time, but there was no... It was local news, so you really didn't find out about it.
They used to give like 48 hours for a kid, and then that was it. Like, well, Timmy didn't come home, and
yeah,
then
that
you
was
gotta
it.
Move on.
You just got to have another kid.
Repaint
That's
his room.
That's why they had like eight kids.
Because
one of them's going to die.
I remember Adam was the big one. Do you remember that kid,
Adam?
Well,
that's when they switched everything up, and they started doing milk cartons.
Yeah.
That was the first Twitter.
That was
like when they did that milk carton shit, right? Yeah.
You'll never see a missing kid on a carton of oat milk.
No.
Yeah. You see a fat guy on the side.
Missing a foot.
Yeah, they just put the
a missing kid, missing friends. That's what you have.
What the fuck is oat milk, by the way? So they got milk. They got all kinds of milk now.
They
right?
got oat. Yeah, you didn't know that?
Where are they getting? How do you get milk from an oat?
I don't know. You soak it in water or something like that.
Water.
Water. Soak it in water, dude.
Get water, dude. Get a towel.
But Adam is when, that was when I was real young. We all had to go and get fingerprinted. Do you remember that? You're too young for this.
Dude, I never fingerprinted. What are you talking about?
I got fingerprinted.
Are you rich?
No, I got rich. Why is that?
You sound like a narc to me. Yeah, who goes and cooperates at a young age?
We all had to go get fingerprinted at the Sears because they were starting.
Sears don't do fingerprints.
Yeah, they do. Mom, tell them. My mom will back me up on this. That kid, John Walsh's son, got kidnapped, and they found him.
Yeah.
All right. Wasn't doing too good.
Yeah. They found part of him, and then the other part later.
Yeah. Poor kid. Yeah. But then that caused, like, a nationwide wave of, you know, of kids getting kidnapped.
Right.
So they had us all go get fingerprinted in case you got kidnapped.
Right.
I don't remember that.
It was the 90s. Probably got a chip in or something.
Dude, I don't remember. I mean, fingerprinting. I got fingerprinted when I was...
They already had yours.
Here comes Bobby Kelly again.
You beat me to my own joke.
You were a second floor man at 13.
I was setting it up. I was right there, and he stepped right on it with a better one.
Three decamen at best.
No.
Hang on. I got to suck on my tongue. I got some moisture.
Here, have some of my coffee.
Oh, my God.
I told you, there's Mountain Dew right behind you.
I'm not going to drink Mountain fucking Dew. Who drinks Mountain Dew?
What about that? You can have that soda up there.
That soda's from my when I was a kid.
He stole that.
Yeah, I'm not fucking touching that. Why don't you just offer me some of that fucking Skippy?
Shout out to the fan that sent that in. Skippy, by the way.
It's Kippy, Bobby. Look, Kippy.
That's my nickname, Kippy.
I know.
Okay, I wasn't sure.
No, I totally got it. I just didn't laugh.
Oh, yikes.
But I did get it.
Before we get into the Patreon questions.
Yes.
I have to know. I don't understand. What's the tiny house? What are we talking about
here? A tiny house is this, okay?
You own a home.
I own my home
right.
in Westchester.
He does pretty well for himself.
Does well.
I'm very modest. I have a nice little ranch, whatever. But then I bought land in New Hampshire. Very cheap.
Did you?
Yes.
Ooh.
Okay.
And then we were going to build.
Trying to subdivide? I got a couple of bucks now. You can have a little tiny.
How many acres?
A little tiny house commune.
A lot of people are doing that.
Yeah, I'm in.
You
guys swingers?
2.5 acres. No, I can't swing on anything.
chewing the two girls and Bobby sleeping.
Yeah, up in a loft. No, the 2.5 acres, but behind it is 600 acres of forest.
Damn.
So it's, you know, that, mm-hmm. you know. But it's up in the White Mountains of New Hampshire, mm-hmm. so which we've all, we go to every year for 30 years. We've been going up there. So I was like, let's just buy the land and see what happens.
Yeah,
we
were
like,
oh. Out.
And then we got, all of a sudden I was on, what was it, Instagram, and I saw the tiny homes in Maine. I was like, this is great.
Yeah.
Because, you know, some of these little things, you know, you buy a prefabbed house, it's a shit house. Mm-hmm. It's just garbage. I didn't want to get, we were thinking about getting a trailer. I was like, that's, dude.
Yeah.
Nobody wants that.
Kind of, and they're cool. They're cool looking. They're fun.
What do you want to do? What do you want to do? What do you
like
do up
fucking
there now?
Clint Eastwood, Any Which Way But Loose. You know what I mean? Right Turn, Clyde, you fucking loser.
I haven't even seen that. I don't know what you're
You
talking.
Never saw?
Was that in black and white?
Oh. I didn't know what the fuck he was talking about, but it was a funny name, so I ran with it.
Any Which Way But Loose. With the monkey.
You never saw the fucking vehicle for Clint Eastwood?
The vehicle.
Any Which Way But Loose?
No.
With the orangutan?
No.
Sounds like a blockbuster hit, though.
Dude, it was. And that was the one where, you know that blonde girl he had in all his movies for a little bit? Do you know Clint Eastwood at all?
I know Clint Eastwood.
Unforgiven?
Come on, what am I, an asshole? That came out my senior high school. I just don't know that. I don't know that stuff, the offbeat stuff. I know High Plains Drifter. I know Pale Rider. I know Dirty Harry.
In between, there was this moment in time where in between the spaghetti westerns and like the Dirty Harry and later on what we know as him, there was this silly fucking, I believe it was in between or the silly, fun Clint Eastwood.
Eastwood was doing comedies?
Dude, hilarious comedies.
Really?
Let's back up. Not hilarious.
There's a fucking orangutan
in it. It's not Smokey and the Bandit.
Couldn't be top notch.
Dude, he made two of them. Any Smokey. Which Way But Loose and Any Which Way You Can, I believe, is the two of them. And
it's like Ernest Goes to Camp, Ernest Goes to School.
He took the fucking orangutan in the zoo to get laid, you know, in the middle of the night. He would just break into a zoo so he can get some pussy, some fucking orangutan puss.
It's got a 37% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Yeah.
The critics' consensus is the inexplicable pairing of Clint Eastwood with an orangutan is the least of Any Which Way But Loose's problems.
Yeah. Okay, but go to the other one. What's the other one? Any Which Way You Can, I believe that's a good one. Now that was a little better. They polished up on the edges.
12 Academy Awards.
They figured it out. They had a tune-up game beforehand.
Dude,
they tweaked the script.
Oh, it's so... And everybody's in it, too. It's like a Cannonball Run type thing.
Oh, okay. The Cannonball Run, I know. Great movie. Love
great
it.
Great movie.
Cannonball Run 1 and 2, correct.
It's in that time when they were making those movies.
Those kinds of movies, sure.
That movie was...
I feel like I'm hanging out with my uncles right now.
I got you.
Bobby, this one's even worse. It's got a 20%. No one's written shit about it.
Oh, you know what? The first one was better. I apologize. The second one was shit.
You can't catch magic in a bottle twice.
Now, where do you see a movie like that? A young kid, Bobby Kelly, out with his 25-year-old friends. You guys go to the movies during the day? You sneak in?
Dude, no, we didn't. You didn't
stab the ticket guy? What happens?
Going to the movies back in the day was an event.
Uh-huh.
It wasn't like a thing you just went to. Like now people go to the movies. I mean, before this shit, you just went to the movies.
You wouldn't go to the movies during the day?
No, because you didn't. No, I was doing fucking drugs and shit, you know, drinking. We were trying to hang out. You didn't go to the. You went to the movies with your family. You went to the movies on vacation.
Yeah.
You know, you didn't go to the.
Fighting the Polacks from Medford during the day. They can't fucking go. They're not going to go catch. Here's another. You got another thing coming or whatever it is.
You got another thing coming.
Hang on. Let me suck on my tongue. There you go. You have a puddle I could sip.
We forgot to get drinks.
I'm going to mail you a case of water.
Yeah.
I don't need you to. I just need one now. I got a house. I got a fucking fountain.
Yeah, T-Bone, you got anything floating over?
You got a Red Bull
you
or
got
something?
A floater?
I mean, Jesus Christ. I mean, I'd take a little piss in a cup. Listen.
That I can arrange. What do you do up in this place? What do you do up in? You go camping up there for the last 30 years?
Well, my uncle back around 30 years ago bought a piece of land up where I bought land on the same street up on Squan Lake where on Golden Pond. Do you know on Golden Pond the movie? Is
my
that too
God.
Much for you?
Yes, I know.
You never saw on Golden Pond?
No.
I mean, what the fuck? I don't know what to say.
He's a young kid, Bobby. What
How
are you
old
doing?
Are you?
I'm 34.
That's not young. That's middle aged.
What year did this movie come out?
It came out when you were alive.
When?
I don't know. I'm not a stats guy. I just told you I'm not a fucking stats guy.
It was Henry Fonda.
Henry Fonda and his daughter.
Yeah.
Jane Fonda.
I mean, she's old to me. I definitely don't know her dad.
Well, that's why I wouldn't. I know the movie, but I didn't see it.
Anyways.
My family was not big fans of Jane Fonda.
Oh, that's right.
Of course. No one is.
They have, what's his name? Hank? No, what's the guy?
Calvin
peeing on Jane Fonda on their house.
On the house?
On the house. I've never seen a house with a bumper sticker. It's the trashiest thing I've ever seen in my life. They have it on the patio door.
I just want to let you know what you're in for when you walk in that house. It's going to be fucking rainbow suspenders and hard hats.
They don't play around.
Yeah, listen. Well, anyways, it's up there. We've been going up there for years. My uncles, three uncles, bought land up there years ago. They would camp on it. Then they built a little house on it.
Okay.
Then they made a nicer house. Mm-hmm. And then my uncle bought the other two out because they stopped going and built a fucking beautiful mansion.
Nice.
I mean, chipping green, a golf course, an archery range, a guest house. He's got another. I mean, it's just really.
Why don't you just get in on that one?
Well,
he wants to do his own thing.
Well, I was a guest there for a long time. He has a guest house, mm-hmm. and we would always go up there.
Right.
And I was like, you know what? We need to stop being guests. I don't want my kid to be a guest.
Yeah, it's tough. Tough look with kids, I feel.
It's
yeah.
like I want my kid. I can't go and do what he did. Like, I don't have the money to buy a house, but we can buy a little piece of land, mm-hmm. and we can make sure there's land behind it, which gives us more land than we actually paid for. Mm-hmm. You know, technically, you can fucking whap back there and crank one out in the woods.
Sure.
If you want.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? And then we found this thing, and it's like tiny homes is not that expensive.
No, you can get
it's like $79,000 for a house.
Yeah,
and they wheel it on, mm-hmm. and you plug it in, and you're good to go. I mean, it's a little more than that, but you
I'm
know.
A big fan of it, man.
Yeah, you can go totally off grid too, though. You literally can plug these in, have water delivered to a thing, and
the
it
tank,
will,
yeah.
And you can be totally off grid on these things. It has a compost toilet. You just shit in it and change out the thing every and throw it in the woods every 3 weeks or whatever like that. So my wife won't do that. She won't shit in anything but a toilet. So we have to get like real plumbing. But
how are you gonna do that?
We don't do it. The guys who do it. But you
probably
just
like a septic tank.
Septic
type thing.
Tank.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you gotta get when you buy land. If you build, you gotta get a well to get mm-hmm. water. And you have to get a septic tank and a leach field.
Which we found out well water we thought was trashy. We didn't grow up with well water. It's not, though. They say it's the best because it's like naturally filtered through limestone or something.
It's coming out of the fucking, it's literally
I don't
coming
know.
Out of the ground. You're getting something that's been in a pipe for 200 years.
Yeah. You got
in
the,
Philly.
That I shit
I run it
at
through
point.
The Brita.
The what?
The Brita.
The Brita?
Brita.
It doesn't have you've taken the filter out probably 3 years ago and never replaced it.
You don't have to really replace it.
Yeah, your Brita looks like a fish tank.
There's a little scuba guy in it.
Yeah.
A little treasure chest bumping up there.
Yeah. So, all right. So that's what it is.
I'm a big fan. Go for it.
And you
do
want
it,
this
baby.
To be this you want it to be your primary residence. You guys are looking at
it's
vacation
a vacation home. You get out, you get away.
Can I just say, you know, being in this business you need it's
I mean, we've been in this business for like 3 months, by the way.
Always,
so let's not get ahead of ourselves.
It's always an option.
But as a comic, in your head, there's always that. We can just go live in the fucking tiny home for $8 a month.
Yeah.
I'll fucking do shows at a deli.
You're at the general store?
I'll panhandle at a fucking fly fishing spot and make money. You know what I mean? There's always that little thing.
Gotcha.
You know?
Yeah. Got to get away.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Plus, when the race wars happen in a couple weeks, I have a place to go.
The cities are getting dicey.
Oh, it's getting dicey. I literally bought this knife. It's fucking nuts out there.
Yeah. Why a knife, though? Are you really going to stab somebody?
I think if he needs to, he will. Yes. Bobby is a little fucking.
But do you think he'll be able to?
This guy's bonkers.
If somebody was going to hurt
me? If someone's coming at him, yeah, it's like a punch.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to do it. I mean, you say I would never even want to, but if somebody was going to hurt me, yeah.
Are you going
to
slash or are you going to stab?
I'm going to slash. I'm not a.
You poke. He's not in a Michael Jackson video. You fucking get him.
Put it right in his thigh. I'm going to go down to the ground and cut his Achilles, and he's going to come chase me, and he can't.
Yeah.
I'm going to slice
still
that.
Still catches you?
That would suck. Did you ever hear? I had a friend of mine, a comic.
Let me get a 10-second head start.
This happened in L.A. This was fucking terrible. He was coming out of a 7-Eleven. Wayne Previty, fucking great guy, passed away last year. But he's coming out of a 7-Eleven, this homeless guy, L.A., you know, they're so aggressive out there. Started getting in his face, and he's like, listen, get the fuck out of my face. I'm going to beat the shit out of you. This guy, fuck you, still in his face. So he starts beating the shit out of this homeless guy. Right?
Okay.
And all of a sudden, he goes to kick him. And he breaks his ankle. He falls to the ground in pain. And he can't move. He's in so much pain. He's just lying on the ground screaming. And he goes, then all of a sudden, I just felt something climbing up my body. It was the homeless guy. He climbed up all the way to his face, nose to nose, and went, I got you now, motherfucker.
That's going to haunt my
just
fucking
just a breath
dream.
On you. I would have passed out.
so you never fucking know. I mean, he was fucking killing it, and then he broke his dumb ankle.
You got to get out while you're ahead, dude.
This guy needs some milk or something. Yeah. Jesus Christ. Holy shit. All right, let's get into some fucking Patreon questions. We got Bobby here. Bobby, thank you so much for coming
got
in.
A hot ep so far.
Hot baby. Ep. Great hot ep. Ep. Love having Bobby.
Yeah, so guys, when you sign up for Patreon, we will ask your garbage question. It's the best way to do it. We just get so many requests otherwise that so when you join, we will answer your garbage questions. This isn't even a garbage question. This came up. This is a jumping off point. This came up last episode and was very fucking divisive in the comments. You're in New York, right? Like, you've been in New York for what, like 20 years or something at this point? Long time.
25 years.
25 years.
25 years.
25 years, New Yorker.
Yeah, I always consider myself a New Yorker.
And you're a, you know, you liked it, you're a food guy. You like your food a certain way.
I get you.
You see what, you have rules.
I appreciate you.
Yes.
I appreciate you pulling back on the.
That's not, it has nowhere where it was going.
He knows his way around a Twinkie.
All right, so you get a.
I didn't expect it from Chubby Finger.
I'm out of control.
You go to a New York bagel place for breakfast, right?
Yeah.
All right?
Excellent.
You have your one, right?
Yeah, I have one in my house, yeah.
Okay. Do you get that? It's a fresh bagel made that day.
Okay.
What do you like? What do you like? Sesame?
Egg.
Like?
Egg.
Hold on. First
egg,
of all.
Egg.
Not too
are you
bad.
Getting, are you getting a bag to go, or are you getting one for yourself or have them make it up? Are you getting like the quarter pound of cream cheese?
Oh, dude. Look, I have three people I got to buy bagels for. I get a dozen bagels.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And I give them to the neighbors. I go over with bagels. I got some bagels. If we don't eat them, I go and I bring them over.
So you're not getting just a sandwich by yourself?
No.
Okay.
Well, let's just say you were by yourself. You're just by yourself.
All right, I'm by myself.
You're by yourself.
You want a bagel.
I want a bagel.
You want a bagel. You're like, I'm going. I'm going to eat it in the car or whatever. Mm-hmm. I'm just having it. This is my breakfast. I'm going to the city for the day to do whatever.
Okay.
Do you get that bagel toasted? It's fresh made that day. Do you get it toasted or no?
I don't.
Hit me.
I don't.
Yes. It's because it's that good, right?
When you get a fresh egg bagel,
Bobby,
you toast it, you fucking ruin it.
You ruin it.
You ruin it. You're not getting the moisture, the softness
the
warmth. It's like a hug when it goes in your mouth, when it hits you a little chubby, and it... And then you bite down, and then it goes between your teeth, and the
gets stuck a little
bit. Oh, fuck!
That's the way to do it. We've been called coastal elites the whole fuck all week because of saying that. It's like New York. If you get a fresh New York bagel, or even Philly, or a fresh East Coast bagel, you can't get a toast. It ruins it.
No, not from a bagel place.
Of course. Now, if you go to a deli or something, it's different because it's not fresh made that day.
You got to toast it to make it right.
Yes.
If you don't, but
100%.
If you're at a bagel place.
If your bagel's coming out of a bag, you got to toast it.
If that thing is warm, you eat that fucker right then and there.
All right. Just wanted to see where you stand.
Absolutely. Yes.
That's the right answer, by the way.
Thank you very much. I'm glad I got the right answer.
Do you eat in the car?
Do I eat in the car?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes, I eat in the car. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So you stop somewhere, you're driving down, you're having a little nosh?
If I do I stop and eat or do I drive and eat?
Drive and eat.
I fucking drive and eat. Yeah, absolutely. There's nothing better.
He's got a turkey dinner on them.
See? Thank you.
Nothing better than having that sandwich. And there's the bites are like the papers perfectly aligned.
And there's no thinking. You don't have to look. You can just do it. It's big.
Bite a little sports talk radio on or something.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Ask and you shall receive.
T-bone.
Oh,
T-bone.
Sparkling water.
That's not coming out of production expenses, by the way.
Did you get a coffee, too?
Jesus Christ.
Oh, you got a whole accoutrement there.
Yeah, you got a little shot of something.
I love him.
T-Bone's the man.
All right, jealous you work with him. You know I love him, right?
Mm-hmm.
What's with the shot? What's going on?
That's a tiny cup of oat milk so that Bobby can try it for the first time.
For the first time.
What'd you put in the coffee?
Put cream, I think.
No, the coffee's black.
Come in this?
No, the coffee's black. I know how you like your coffee. So the coffee is black.
Yeah. No, the coffee ain't black. No. I got news for you.
There's stuff in it.
Yeah, there's something.
It's a little light.
Oh, she fucked up. She gave me she mislabeled the shit.
Oh, okay. Yours is yours. I'm sorry I touched it, but I didn't touch the cup.
It's all right. They got the vaccine.
Yeah.
We're all right.
And I don't have it.
Hey, T-Bone's bucking for
I know.
Bucking for a new gig here. Well, hey, I don't like
T-Bone,
this at
what
all.
What the fuck? I never got a coffee, T-Bone.
T-Bone, stay here. Trust me. Stay here. I want to come. I want to. Let's just put. Let me do T-Bone's.
Do you know how to do subtitles? You're hired.
Yeah. Fucking subtitles suck. Oh, I hate the cocksucker. We should do subtitles. Oh, everybody's got to do subtitles. Your manager.
I don't know how you do it.
You should do subtitles. Fucking assholes. Fuck off.
Drive me crazy. There you go. Now you got a coffee and you got
look
a water.
At this.
You happy?
I knew that's where you were going. I love it. Power move by T-Bone.
It's a fuck.
Flex on these.
Look
pussies.
At him. Fucking two drinks, Kelly over here. Jesus.
From well, nothing to something.
I've been talking for 45 minutes with nothing in my mouth except my own saliva.
Did you try the oat milk, Bobby? What do you think?
I didn't try. Oh, a little. I'm three boning. That is fucking good.
Yeah, it's good, right? They know what they're doing.
Oatly is the big company. Oatly.
That's like drinking oatmeal.
Yeah. Oatly is the good. Big company.
I mean, that's not the craziest thing to say. It's oatmeal.
A lot of celebs are investing in that company. So if you have a little left over from the tiny house, you could drop a little in there.
Wall Street bets all of a sudden? What the fuck? A lot of famous people are investing in that company.
I'm in the know. What do you want?
I'm in the know. I'm going to go fuck it. My wife would kill me. I got no fucking money. I just bought a dumb tiny house and a fucking plot of land. You want to invest in what? Go fuck yourself. Go make money, fat boy. Go back on the road and sell. Sorry, go ahead.
That being said, we'll be in Raleigh, Nashville, Chicago,
that's
and Indy.
Right.
Get those tickets, baby. All right, let's get into some fucking
when
questions.
When are you in Chicago?
When? Yeah. June 21st or something like that. I don't know. I should know this, but
I'm
in
Chicago, too. That would have been great if we were both there.
We'd love that.
Link up.
You're doing the Laugh Factory, right?
Laugh Factory, yeah.
What up? Yeah, this guy fucking knows where he knows every movie he's making.
Who are you? Whose side are you on?
Yeah, what's
he's
going
on
here?
Everybody's side.
No. He's got a non-compete clause. I made him sign.
Listen, first of all, I had Toby first, okay? Don't get carried away, all right?
He's not wrong. Bobby really helped me change my life a little bit.
Yeah, that's my.
I know.
My guy first that you guys fucking stole.
Sure did.
No.
Meet me in the pack.
You
tomorrow.
Go tell everybody in the pack, too. We got Toby. All right? Toby's running with the boys now.
They got Toby.
Mikey Ohm. Mikey Ohm.
Hey, Jimmy Gags. They got T-Bone.
Jake, they got T-Bone.
I'm going to give him a cool nickname, too.
Yeah, bring your camera and some brass knuckles. We're going to be in Asbury Park.
I'm fucking loving this.
Asbury Park. That's how non-New York he is.
Bobby's hooked.
Yeah. I like the cup, too. I love a mini.
I got you the oat milk to put it in your coffee. Oh,
that's a full-size cup.
Oh, it goes in my coffee. I didn't know that. Sorry, buddy. I thought you told me to take a sip of it.
He's drinking like it's a nip of Fireball.
Don't you? That's why I love Japanese.
I love those. Yeah, anything minis. Like that. Yeah, it's adorable.
Oh, my God.
Big fan.
Did I just get canceled for saying that?
No, they're good at engineering and stuff like that and packaging.
Oh, I think that's okay. So good. I love that. Go ahead.
All right, let's get into it. These are the Patreon questions, garbage questions for Baby Kelly. All right, first one coming in. And you as a kid, and then also now that you're a dad, did your parents let you curse as a kid?
No.
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 Would you let it fly and then get in trouble, or was it like you just knew not even to cross the line?
You don't. I mean, I did. I mean, you know. I mean, I did fuck up. I wound up cursing.
You were bad on the outside. You weren't bad in the house. Like, you weren't bad to your mom, were you?
No. Like, I had a big Irish Catholic family. I had my grandmother, my grandfather, and 13 of us. We 13 of us lived in a 3-bedroom for a long part of my life. So I had I have a great family. 5 uncles, 2 aunts. My grandfather and grandmother. So I never fucked around in front of them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But, you know, my mom got married to this other guy who was an asshole.
Right.
And then I kind of turned.
Was he in the house with you, with the 13 people?
No, we moved out. Okay. That's when we moved out, and that's when kind of things went to shit.
Right.
So, you know, I started hanging out with the wrong crew, blah, 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 and I wound up swearing. But I think also coming from Boston, you use fuck in the middle of a word.
It's the same. You know? It's the same thing. It's like, so I curse too much.
Yeah, it's like in my set, I swear a lot, and I don't have to.
But that's how you rhythmically talk.
It's how I talk. Fucking guy, cocksucking, fucking
exactly.
Motherfucker.
Yeah.
You know, it just comes out that way.
Do you curse in front of Max?
I try not to. But he loves cursing.
So you catch your finger in the grill or something like that.
Yeah,
not
shit
that
like
fuck
that. Yeah, like a box this morning. She left a box in the hallway that blocks the hall. You got to do a tightrope to get through the fucking hallway. And I tripped over it 7 times. And I was like, fucking box.
Fuck him.
And then I got called. And he's like, he'll come up and be like, Dad. But he likes to swear a lot.
What's he say?
Really?
What's his go-to?
We just went to a... I'll play this for you if you want. We just went to the amusement park out in American Dream by Giant Stadium.
Okay.
Have you heard of that?
Is that the new one, indoor
one?
The water park?
It's huge.
Wait,
water
what?
Park.
It's that new mall they built, like right next to Giant Stadium.
Oh, really?
It's off the turnpike, or off the off the turnpike.
Ooh, yeah, amusement. They got a water park, amusement.
The water park comes out of the building and comes back in. You see it? I drive by it. It's up by the bridge.
You can go skiing. They have a ski slope.
Yeah, yeah, what?
So we go on the thing. He doesn't want to go on the roller coaster. I'm like, listen, you go on the roller coaster, and I go, you can swear. I go, you can swear one time. He goes, four.
I go. That's a hard bargain.
I go two.
You fucking quacksucking piece of fucking shit.
He goes. I go two. He goes three. I go. Three times. So we go down the roller coaster.
What do you mean you're going to swear? How much? Not a lot. Oh, Jesus. Not a lot.
I hate roller coasters.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
He's letting them fly.
I don't know if you can hear it over my screaming.
Yeah. Bobby's like, here's this video of me being a pussy.
But a couple of dirt balls.
So, 17 shits, by the way.
The other families were like, what the fuck?
Wait, this is outside? The roller coaster's
outside? Inside.
It's inside.
You're fucking so ghetto. You're still on the inside fucking.
Yeah, he can't. They didn't do much as a family.
I mean, he's like,
he's learning a lot.
Wait a minute, this is inside? Yeah, they do that now.
Bobby, he thought the entire Epcot Center was inside the ball.
He swear to God. Up until last week.
Oh, my God.
I've never been there.
The ball's not even that big.
I've never been.
He thought it was the size of Orlando, apparently.
That's what I thought it was.
People, I was talking about
anytime
the country.
Somebody says Epcot Center, it's that fucking golf ball. That's what I thought
it
was.
Every time they say Paris, they show the fucking Eiffel Tower. Doesn't mean it's the whole fucking city.
Yeah, nobody said Epcot Center in 15 years, by the way, since they opened Universal.
That's true.
Oh, is that what it's called?
Universal.
No, it's the new one.
It's the new one. It's way better.
It's way better than
you could literally get fucking grasshopper frog chocolates and fly on Harry Potter's train, and it's crazy. You can do
what the fuck? Grasshopper fly chocolates,
dude. You can go to Harry Potter's village, right? I'm not even kidding you. Buy a wand.
I'm a wizard, dude. I'm gonna go fight in the pack.
Bring your wand.
With my wand.
Ipsno Capiro. You're deado, you cocksuckero.
What, I can't say Voldemort? I'll say it. I don't care. I'm not scared.
Some kid from Slytherin got cut up real good. They sliced his fucking throat. They found him over in the pack.
But
bunch of Susie Q's all over him.
You
think
going
it was Bobby.
Susie. What's a Susie Q?
That's what he said.
Oh, okay. You don't know what a Susie Q is?
No.
Oh, you're
he's shoehorned it into five jokes.
Of course I do.
What is it?
Went to high school with her.
It was the name of a dry cleaner in my neighborhood.
You know what a ring ding is?
Yeah.
All right, you know what a yoo-hoo is?
A yoo-hoo? Like the milk yoo-hoo?
No, not a yodel. A yodel. Yeah. You know what a yodel is?
Fucking asshole? Well, of course.
Are you familiar with Drake's?
A yodel.
Pastry coffee. Line.
Yeah.
Well, first
That's
of
what
all,
he's
a
asking.
Yodel and a ring ding, very similar, just different shapes. Am I right?
You are wrong.
And then, no.
A ring ding is round and covered in chocolate. A yodel doesn't have any chocolate.
It's just
oh,
the
no,
cake.
You're right. What the ding dong is what I'm talking
ding
about.
Ding dong's close.
The
yeah,
ding dong has is a similar to
it's
the.
Chocolate on the outside.
Similar to the ring ding.
Isn't the ding dong more of a. Ring or is that the
but
ring?
But now you have now. Here's the thing: you have the ding dong, and the yodel.
A couple of ding dongs.
Very very
here.
Very exotic. It's too much. It's too rich.
I love
but
it.
But then you have the devil dog too dry.
Sure.
I mean it's too dry. But then you have the Susie Q.
Yes. I got
which
you right
is
here.
Right in
oh,
the middle.
Oh, it's like the cake.
Yes.
It's
right
like
in
the
fucking middle.
Okay.
It's moist enough, and it's not dry, but it's not too rich, and it comes with two big. You when I was a kid.
It's
came
a deal.
With two. It's a fucking deal. So I always went Susie Q.
Pop one of those in the freezer.
I didn't know him.
Oh, motherfucker. I've never thought of that in my life. You fat genius. I've never thought of
He's
that
like
in
Picasso,
my life.
He's like Picasso, some say.
My this fucking,
He's in his frozen period right now.
Why didn't I think of that? That's the first fat
Dude, he
guy
he freezes
with
everything. Everything. You can say anything. You'd be like, do you ever have a Jolly Ranch in a
You get a whole second.
Icebox?
You get a whole second life out of snacks by putting them in the freezer.
God,
my
God.
Nephew told me last
I
summer.
I put him in the freezer. 2 weeks, not too bad.
My nephew told me to put Sour Patch Kids in
I
the freezer.
It.
Thank you.
I almost spilled his coffee. Yeah.
Woo.
Anyways,
all right, we're having a good time.
All right, let's keep moving here. This is from Casey.
It's inside, huh?
You've never been to an inside amusement park,
dude. He's never been
an inside
anywhere.
Amusement park. That's somebody's house.
Why
what
don't
mean?
You? Why don't you make a day of it? Why don't you go?
Well, we didn't know this existed.
I knew it existed. I've been just never adventure. My mind wasn't blown by it.
I believe.
I've never driven by a mall and been like, I should take Foley there. I just assume you've been to one before.
They're opening a comedy club in that mall.
Yeah, I know who is.
Who is it?
I don't. Should we say?
Why not?
I was told not to.
All right, then don't.
By the person.
Well, then don't.
Okay.
why would you need a dad talk? Should I say? They told me not to. Okay. By the person. No, then you
okay.
don't.
Why is it, I wasn't sure if we were living on the edge or something.
Well, did you ever watch a mob movie in your life? What the fuck? Jesus Christ, what part of town are you from? Should I tell everybody? They told me not to, but I will if you say so.
Should I tell the cops we killed this guy? What do you think? What do you think, boss? Should I go tell him?
Huh? Bobby said not to.
Bobby said not to, but I'm going to go tell him anyway.
Man.
So hard. So funny to see him fight his shitty Philly accent to do my accent. Bobby said, wah, your mouth fails in the middle of it.
I'm not good at either one of them.
So what's up?
I found from doing the show more, my Philly accent comes out even more, which is not good. All right, this is from Casey. Have you ever used a butter knife to unscrew something?
Fuck yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Of course.
Did you ever pull that one out of the drawer and it's bent while you're trying to cut chicken or something?
Yeah.
It's like twisted at the end.
Well, here's the thing though. Butter knives changed because the fucking yuppie cocksuckers, they tried to make a butter knife.
Take it easy.
Yeah, Jesus.
Like easy on the Oatly, will you?
How did yuppies change butter knives?
Because a butter knife used to be.
Because that was the root of all evil when he was a kid.
The big yuppies round one.
Was a round at the end.
The big guy.
Now they tried to make them pointy, so it's a half butter knife. You could use it for chicken.
Yeah.
Not steak, but chicken or pork. Mm-hmm. You can use so you have one knife that does everything, which is bullshit. I like a nice, but there's nothing like a butter. I can only drink out of a certain cup for coffee. I have to have a separate cup for tea. I can't drink out of any
old cup. What's the difference of the cups?
Well, a teacup, I like it to be a little bigger because I want, you know, tea, you whap down a little bit. A coffee cup, I like to be a little smaller because I don't want, you know, I like a nice good cup of coffee, but not too much.
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me. It's fucking.
I like it. He's got his reasons. As long as somebody can back something up, I'm fine with it.
The butter knife, I like when it's
the big guy. You get a nice spread to it.
You get a spread. It's not going to hurt anybody. You know what I mean?
Do you keep your butter in the fridge or on the counter?
What? No. Who the fuck wants to scrape it like ice, like it's
a
Hawaiian ice?
You insult him with that question.
You keep it on the counter like a fucking human being.
Overnight?
Yes.
Yeah, do you have a butter tray? Or you just leaving it out?
Well, what am I, a fucking yuppie? Butter tray.
Dude, a butter tray is not yuppie. That's been around since the fucking...
It's a big thing on the podcast. Putting your butter in the fridge or keeping it on the counter.
Butter on the counter... With a butter tray.
Yes, of course.
That's for rich people to
make. And you should only do the Irish butter if you're a good person.
The Kerrigan's or whatever?
Yeah, Kerrigan's butter is.
Kerrigold.
I don't know why there's any, whatever the fuck it is. There's other butter.
I'm using Irish spring.
Kerrigold is the Rayos of butter.
Yeah.
You can't go back.
I
had some on Sunday. We did the corned beef and cabbage at my brother's for St. Patty's Day.
Sounds like a nice breakfast.
Oh, it was great.
I liked it.
Thanks.
Hey, he
He's
laugh.
Too slow sometimes.
He's just slow.
when he's talking about food or family, he zones comedy out and just gets stuck on it.
I don't know.
All right, this is from Frank. How long have you used a phone with a cracked screen?
I not that long.
I mean, I am fucking chat. I don't have a bottom of my phone. Look at that.
Bobby
that
Sharp.
That fell off the other day.
I immediately get it fixed.
You're a big technology guy.
I'm in a bad way.
Love the iPhone. When the iPhone came out, I'm such a nerd. I was like, they finally did it. They did it. And I love the iPhone so much.
You do?
Oh, I love the fucking, just everything it does is just crazy. I left the house the other day without my wallet. My wallet's on the back.
Uh-huh.
Right here. I left without that.
Wait, is that stuck to it?
It's a magnet.
It's a magnet.
My wife's got the same thing. Yeah,
it's the best fucking right
here. I would never be
He's
able
to. Such a gadget
Wouldn't
guy.
You worry?
Magback wallet case. Sponsor these fucking podcasts, Magback.
Wouldn't you worry about it falling? It doesn't fall, huh?
No, it doesn't fall.
Wow.
Bobby has never said no to
Whoa,
an Instagram ad.
Look at that.
Yeah. Looks pretty
that.
Good.
Yeah, and this is magnet too, so you can stick it on the fucking, you know, wherever. You know?
Sure.
But yeah, I went out of the house with just this the other day, and I bought everything I needed with just my phone.
I'm just learning how to do that. It's pretty fucking
Apple
crazy.
Apple Pay.
Well, yeah.
All of it. Yeah, it's all set. Yeah.
You tap it.
Right? Do you remember where you were when you first saw the iPhone?
I love that when something hits his brain, it just comes out.
Oh, yeah.
We were talking, and all of a sudden he went, Apple Pay.
I got the chip, right?
He's more of a candy Apple Pay kind of guy, but.
Love a candy apple.
Zoom in on that, Tebow.
Love a candy apple. You a candy apple guy, Bobby?
I fucking despise it.
Really?
It is the worst snack.
Yes, thank you.
It was made for horses.
Yeah. Somebody didn't get one at the fair, that's why.
I always got them. You eat them and you might as well fucking rip your teeth out, and then you're eating an apple. It's a fucking apple.
Yeah, the candy's going quick.
I mean, is there a lettuce apple, a candy apple? I mean, what the fuck is
candy
that?
Candy lettuce?
What about a caramel apple? You don't like a caramel apple?
I don't like apples and fucking... That stupid snack sucks a bag of dicks. The only one that I'll fucking allow is the one that they just dip in chocolate like nine times.
I don't think I've ever had that.
Yeah. Oh, they do that. They dip it in chocolate and then they pour shit on it. I might do that.
I can
the
get down with that. That sounds up my fucking wheelhouse right there.
When you bite into a caramel apple, your fucking teeth, and they stick immediately.
It's all over here and shit. Get the fuck out of here.
And it's always that shit apple, too.
Yeah, what are you hanging out at a fucking orchard?
The Granny Smith?
It's that shit one. They never get those. What's the first
one? Delicious?
Red Delicious is garbage.
I've recently turned, as I got older, turned into the green guy. Granny Smith guy.
Granny Smith can go fuck. I'd rather eat.
Dumb broad.
I'd rather eat the old lady's vagina and asshole at the same time.
Hey, get over here. Pull your shirt up, Tuts.
You literally make the same face.
It does get you back here.
It gets
you in the jowls a little bit.
Oh,
man.
All right.
Next one. I've had this. This is from Ryan. Have your parents ever purchased your birthday cake while they were grocery shopping with you?
Oh, yeah.
Like, have you ever been standing there like, go grab a cake for your birthday?
I remember one. It's a sad look. That's all I remember. I remember
one birthday.
And I got in trouble. And I remember being on the stairs crying. That's all I remember.
You only remember one birthday?
I don't. Let me think. Let me really think back. No, I don't remember as a kid having a birthday.
Damn.
I'm sure it happened.
Toby, go grab a birthday cake. He's just angling for us to get him a birthday cake.
You spelled Bobby wrong. God damn it.
I'm sure it did.
But
you
give
Bobby
a birthday cake and he'd be like, vanilla? I mean, I want a chocolate, but it's pretty good.
I like vanilla.
What is your cake, by the way?
Yellow cake with milk chocolate frosting.
Okay.
With chocolate frosting. Yellow cake.
OG.
Yellow cake, but here's the thing. My wife makes it. It is the best cake on the planet. It's yellow cake, but she puts Jell-O in it to make it moist.
Okay? I don't understand it, but I don't hate it.
So, and then the of course, the chocolate milk.
Oh, Jell-O pudding.
The pudding in it. She puts pudding in it, and it makes it.
I thought you meant green jelly.
Jell-O.
I was like, all right, man.
Pudding. Sorry.
Screwball.
Pudding. Putting in it, it makes it, I mean, dude.
I put stovetop in the cake.
I fucking hate stovetop.
Really?
What?
You're fucking
garbage. That's it. Pack your shit. Get
out
of here,
crazy.
Bobby. I've heard enough.
I'll tell you why. My wife makes a fucking fourth generation stuffing from her grandmother's, her mother's great grandma, whoever the fuck it was, some old broad.
I don't think stuffing's been around for four generations.
Some Polack that fucked an American Indian made
sure
a stuffing
is,
with fucking sauce. I mean, dude, it's the best.
And is there sausage in it?
Of course there is.
Yeah. That's different than stovetop.
You put sausage in
breakfast
the stovetop.
Sausage. Breakfast sausage.
That's the way to do it. That's what my mom does. That's the way to do
breakfast
it.
Breakfast sausage has a spice in it.
Yeah.
That
it's got the
makes,
little orange flakes.
There's something in it that makes it. Exactly.
You mean the maple links? Like the little Jimmy Deans?
Jimmy Deans. Yeah. Whatever. Yeah.
They're whatever.
So good. Breakfast sausages are off the
That's the best
chart.
Thing about Thanksgiving is my mom makes the sausage and then there's a bunch extra and I'll have it for breakfast. Like when I come down all hungover, fucking make a sandwich of that.
Right.
Good night, daddy. Oh, that's man. It.
Yeah. Those things are crispy, though. I like it.
Yeah, so there you go.
So wait, just one birthday you remember?
I don't remember. I remember that birthday, but I don't remember getting cakes. I don't remember it. And now
you go all out for the kid now, I assume.
We do a birthday party every year at my house, and I invite. The last time it was last year, it was only 20 people, but before COVID, it was 60 people.
Mm-hmm.
I got a bouncy house. I got a zip line.
I saw the Instagram stories.
I hired a fucking clown and a
60
magician.
60 presents we're looking at potentially.
Well, I invite all my comic people, right? Mm-hmm. Like, you know, Colin, Norton, Gallman, Hamilton, fucking Gomez, all those fucking people come up.
They're all standing in the corner talking shit to the clown. Like, this guy's a fucking hack. He's been doing the same bits as the 80s.
It kind of does that. I mean, and then all of my kids' friends come and their parents. So that does happen. Like, all the comics just cluster.
Sure.
And trash.
Check out that fucking dork in the shorts or whatever, you know.
Yeah. Well, that, hold on. That brings up something I'm interested in.
Yeah.
If you can say this, yeah. I would like to know who's the best gift-giver out of your successful comedian friends.
I know right now. Dante.
Dante Nero.
Dante Nero.
What's he drop on the kid?
Gary Goldman. It's Dante and Gary.
Really?
But Dante
Love
Nero.
Gary.
Picture Colin.
No, Colin. Now, Colin did give a great gift. He is a great gift gifter. He would, probably Colin would be the one. But Dante goes so overboard.
Sure, I can see that.
I mean, he bought him this.
Great guy.
He bought him this. I mean, it's like a big wheel.
Damn.
But it's automatic.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you can sit in it and fucking drive around the neighborhood at 5 miles an hour. It's
nuts. Go get the paper with it.
Go get some bagels.
You know what I mean? Yeah, he goes nuts. He bought him. And I was like, Dante's so great. But then Dante had a kid. I'm like, fuck, now I'm
now fine. You're fine. Now you're out 200 clams every year.
So now I got to fucking. You know?
Oh, shit.
That brings this up. If you're going to a wedding, say you were going to Foley's wedding.
Yeah.
What are you dropping at a wedding?
First of all, I'm not going.
That's fucking fantastic.
Nah, I'm just not happy.
Are you going to make up an excuse? Like, I think I'm traveling.
Oh, no, no. I'm going to go. I'm not coming.
I'm not coming.
No, I don't go to weddings anymore.
Really?
I do not. I think it's garbage. Weddings are a scam. Weddings are a fucking fantasy. Weddings is a waste of money and a whore. You might as well just buy land in a tiny home and fucking.
This guy's in a tiny home pyramid scheme, you know, trying to get you involved.
Or buy something.
The money's in the licenses, dude.
Buy a fucking timeshare. Put money in the bank. Get stocks. You're wasting thousands of dollars on a day to pretend like you're royalty.
Sure.
And that's shit to me. I think you should take all that money,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
Just have a part. Go get elope. Go on your vacation.
Yeah.
And then have a little party after and let everybody come and drop a check. You can have the money. I don't care. You can have the money. But I'm not fucking dropping bills on a shit day of just
getting a hotel somewhere
for
or something.
You
yeah.
fucks. I'm your minions. Like, I'm your, hey. The
but
first.
You had it. You had a wedding.
I did not. I eloped.
You did. Where'd you go?
Yes. I went to Maui, which sucked.
You know what, Hawaii?
This guy sounds like a good time.
Really?
Well, because I love Aruba. I wanted to just go to Aruba. She was like, I'll do it, but I want to elope, but let's do it in Maui. I'm like, that's a fucking $10,000 trip.
Yeah.
And look, God bless Maui. I love you people. Yeah, I think you're my people,
by the
way.
Why'd he bless himself?
I don't know.
Because I bless the people of Maui. they're big people. You see those people?
They think Bobby's a god. A
couple of big guys.
They're big guys, big women.
Yeah.
Those fucking women.
What are they? Is that Samoan or something?
Samoan and Hawaiian.
They're people of Samoan descent, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were conquered by
big
Captain
dudes.
Cook back in the day for nails. He tricked them with nails.
Who?
Captain Cook. He's the guy who discovered Hawaii. Then they murdered him on
just
the boat.
Just turn into fucking Wikipedia real quick.
Welcome back to Bad History with Bobby Kelly. They got fucking scammed over there.
Shook a keychain, distracted him, stole the whole island.
So,
look it up. You don't believe me? Look it up. Right, go to Wikipedia.
Not now. Wait till I leave. Then look it up.
It's true.
Not now. Wait till I don't embarrass me.
But
you got more of that oat milk?
I fucking love some. It was sweet. But yeah, no.
Right, so no weddings. I get it. That's good.
Weddings are a waste of fucking money and a waste of time, and you don't like all those people, and you're fucking up their day. Nobody wants to go.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody truly wants to go. Everybody wakes up on wedding day and goes, fuck. All right, let's go. Put that stupid suit on. Get the thing. Go to the thing. Go to the church. You're going to be crying. And you see them up there being phonies. You know, they were doing ass play the night before, and she's wearing white right now.
Sure,
get the fuck out of here. And then you got to go to the stupid venue, and you got to wait for them to show up.
And then there's an entrance.
And they're doing photos, and everybody's starving. Then by the time you eat, it's shit. Mm-hmm. Then you got to do the stupid wah-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. It's like, go fuck yourself. God bless you.
What,
you
get married at a bowling alley?
Yeah,
the chicken dance.
I mean, they're still doing the
chicken
dance?
Every,
when was the last time you were at a wedding?
Yeah, no shit.
Every wedding I've ever been to does the fucking chicken dance. It's like a thing. And even if you don't
even know what that is, yeah.
It's a chicken dance.
I mean, we did it at a roller skate.
Maybe a macarena.
At the roller skate.
Colin had a good wedding.
Yeah, he's got a little bit of cash to throw around.
I'll tell you why Colin's wedding was good. He did everything in the same spot.
That's one. Dude,
wait,
I went to my
first
wedding.
Recently? Did he get married recently, or was this back in the day?
It was a couple years ago.
Okay. I went to my first wedding that did that. Yeah. They got married in like the one side of the building, and then you walked 10 feet to the reception hall, and I was like, you can do this? Yes. They had a bar at the ceremony, which was fantastic.
So what'd you give Colin? Can we ask that? Since that was that the last wedding you went to?
We actually, we hired an artist. We commissioned an artist to do a painting for him.
Huh. Of who?
Of him and,
so his, of him and his wife?
Yeah, me and Dawn. We're just in his living room right now like this. Fucking asshole.
Oh, he's got big black glasses on.
Painting a Rodney Dangerfield. Clint Eastwood and the orangutan.
Well, here's the thing. Here's the problem with that. This artist was I really like, and we commissioned him to do this.
That's classy. That's very classy.
And it was
him. I don't know about that.
No, it is. You're commissioning an artist that you like.
Cash.
Dude, what are you talking about? He's got money.
He's got money. That's he was true. On SNL.
You cash. Him money. He's got it.
Yes, give me Venmo now. Yeah. How about that?
That's like giving you chips.
Give me a painting.
A couple of Suzy Q's on the cop patio.
Yeah.
Go ahead. You're a good kid. Oh, geez. Thanks, Bob. I don't know what to say. You got the family back.
We commissioned. But here's the problem with that, because it's art, which is subjectable, like stand up. Mm-hmm. You know, you're not everybody.
It stinks.
Right? Well, no. No, fuck you. I know you're trying to.
I don't think you're happy with how it came out, though.
I loved it.
And now, hold on. When you say commissioned, is this a formal process, or did you find some bozo that paints paintings?
Sorry, I went down to Washington Square Park, and I had a guy with a spinny art thing, and he spun it. Yes, I can.
Look at this. It's a sunset.
You went to Sears and got fingerprinted. And
it's Colin driving in a little car.
I went down to the Jersey Shore. It's just big head Colin. No, I commit. It's an artist. He did it. I loved it. It's a beautiful piece. And my wife loved it. We were very happy with it. We gave it to them. But then here's the thing with art is that, you know, after you give somebody a gift, you're waiting for that response.
Mm-hmm.
You give somebody money, you just, that's it. You're done.
Yeah,
goodbye.
Yeah, it's
you
a transaction.
It's a transaction.
You're looking you're for, oh, my hear, God, Bobby, we
got
love
situated.
It.
We settled. It's in the main mantelpiece.
You're waiting to hear, hey, Bob. Hey, what's up? Listen, man, we're on a hunt. I can't believe you did
fantastic.
That.
Fantastic.
Never came.
Hmm.
Wow.
So I had to go. You know what I mean? And I was like,
you
hey.
Stole it back.
No, I had to call him up and be like, listen, man, hey, did you like the painting? Oh, yeah. Oh, that wasn't good.
Ooh.
No. And then he goes, no.
You knew he didn't like it.
I go, you know, Jen, yeah, we're going to hang it. I go, well, it's not that I didn't like it. And then it was like, you want me to just take it back? I can take it back. I'll keep it. I'll put it up in my house. We love you, too. That'd be hilarious. Just we have a wall of art. Like original art in our house from people.
Painting a Colin Quinn.
Just call the. But.
Biting his knuckles.
But then he finally called me up later. He goes, let me tell you, that really grew on us. We really love
that's
it.
A lie, though. You know that.
No.
Where'd he put it? Where'd he put it? Where'd he
Colin
hang it?
Quinn is too
it's
funny.
True. He's too funny to lie
he would,
like that.
There's nothing that he would like better than to not like it and have us and be like, yeah, we think it stinks. He would love to do that. It did grow on him. So. Well, it's like I tell you, my therapist,
Alan. I went, yeah.
Okay, great. He says to me, I was talking about art. I used to do art before comedy. I went to art school. I was going to be an art teacher. He goes, you should paint again. So I went and bought all the shit. I got my easel up, my French U. I start painting in the living room. I take it over the whole room. My wife fucking hates it. I paint this painting, and I my first painting I give to him. I guess this is for you.
To Alan?
Alan.
Oh, yeah.
I give it to him because he's got all the art in the office from clients.
Right? Okay.
So a year later, we actually have an argument. I'm fighting with this fuck. And I'm yelling at him. And he's like, you did it? And I go, yeah. And I go, fuck you. And where's my painting? I want it up.
This guy's nuts.
I want my painting up the next time I come here. You put all this shit out, you fucking... And the next time I came, if you come out of the bathroom, it's right in front of the shitter. He put my painting up right there. So if you ever go there, it's right there. It's, yeah.
Who's the painting up? Of him?
It's of Colin Quinn.
Do you want to see it?
Yes,
I do. I'll see if I can find it. What's the next question?
Wait, did Colin ever confirm with you that your painting was put up? Did you witness it in his home?
I don't know. Should I call him and ask him?
No.
Call
him.
You sure?
Yes. No, I'll do it.
All right.
Right. Put him on the spot. What about Verzi's wedding? Didn't you go to Verzi's wedding?
Was that on the spot?
Yeah, Verzi got married like fucking 25 years ago.
What are you talking? I didn't even know Verzi.
Oh, you didn't?
No, I did, but I didn't go to his wedding.
Well, the last wedding. What's? I want to know the what last the wedding cash was amount Bobby Kelly's dropping at
if
a
you
wedding.
Were going.
20 minutes I've been waiting to hear this.
All right, here, I'm doing $200 a person.
Class.
A person?
Yeah. A person.
So yes. You and your wife come to my wedding, you're giving me $400?
I guess you just got invited to Foley's wedding.
I'm not.
It's just going to be the four of us.
If I'm coming to your wedding, I'm giving $200 a pop. Yeah.
Nice.
Because I got to pay for the meal.
You got to cover your plate.
I got to cover my plate, but I want to cover the people working there too. So I'm going to go 150 for your shit chicken or whatever the fuck you got. And I'm going to do $50 for the people that are working there.
Bobby
which
is a
why I don't go to weddings. Because I hate dropping that much money on some day that I don't even fucking want to be at.
Sure. I get it. I didn't invite you to mine.
I went to a wedding where they had a 4-hour break in between the wedding and the reception.
Oh, my God.
We had to go to McDonald's.
You didn't have to.
I'm sure there was a salad.
We were
works.
Contractually obligated to hit the Mickey D's 3 miles
I'm
away.
Sure there was a Sweet Greens or something in the area.
Yeah, even a Chipotle or something.
We had to go to McDonald's.
All right, but we got to get out of here a couple minutes. Let's run through a few more.
I'll save the painting.
All right, this is from Connor Hicks. This is a pretty good one. How do you open a disposable straw wrapping? Is it to hold the straw in the fist and bang on the bottom? Or do you do like the classy rip and pull out? Do you leave
like
the top
that.
On?
From my
I'm an animal. The Neanderthal.
Break the straw.
And then teeth.
Break the straw.
You break the straw, then you're fucked. If it's
There's
your
nothing
only straw,
worse.
You break the straw. And
you got to have good technique, though. You got to be soft.
Buddy, you don't know, though. You don't know what type of straw you're dealing
McDonald's
with.
McDonald's can withstand them.
Listen, you break that straw, you crack that fucking straw,
it's over.
And you're done.
And you're drinking like this, like an asshole.
That's how I prefer it, though. I drink from a straw too quick. I got good suction. I'm like a Dyson. It's all fucking
gone.
If you
have a crack in that straw, you're not sucking anything.
True, that's what I'm saying.
You're getting maybe halfway through the drink.
You peel the top off like a fucking person.
Wow, that's clay. I don't do that.
Oh, but can I say this? I peel the top off, and then I tap it. So I do both, actually. I peel and then tap.
Oh, I know what you're saying.
Yeah, and then
I
still go, I'm 50 and I still go like that.
I don't hate it.
I'm a big fan of that.
I waited tables for so long that I can just do the rip and then put the straw in with the little piece of paper.
Which
still
he's
on
gone and like he's grabbed us iced coffees and he comes back with that, which is pretty, it's a nice touch. I'll
nice
give
touch.
You that.
That is a nice touch. I do like that.
When your buddy, you
I licked the straw.
Kinda, yeah, you're already kind of disgusted by him when he hands you a sanitized straw. It's not too shabby.
Look at my fingers.
Yeah, you know he's licked his fingers.
Oh, dude. He skeeves me to if you knew.
My fingernails get real dirty out of nowhere.
I noticed. You look like a coal miner for some fucking
I know.
Reason.
Out of nowhere.
This
I
is his only
why.
Job is to show up here twice a week. And
yeah. Every once in a while, I look down like, I don't know how. I just took a shower and scrubbed everything. I don't know where it's coming from.
I'll tell you where.
It's boogers.
You're fucking everywhere.
Yeah, dude.
Stop touching shit.
Yeah. This is the guy fucking touching my straws. Great question.
Yeah, fantastic. I think for the record, though, yeah, banging it is trash because you are going to snap it.
If you peel it and tap. I like a tap.
I don't like straw. If I'm at a McDonald's or Chipotle or something, I go no straw. I take the lid off and I go no straw.
That's just nuts.
That's weird.
That's fucking. You're drinking the whole drink.
I like to live on the wild
you
side.
You don't even let it. You can't even let it sit for a minute. You have to drink the whole fucking thing.
Why?
You're gonna put the lid back on? And,
yeah.
No, what do you mean if I'm walking around?
What type of balance do you have not to spill a fucking?
What in the
sure.
Wait in the car? Or
yes.
Where are we talking?
Yes, at all.
Who's eating in the restaurant?
You two chubbies are just talking about eating in the car. Immediately, that's the same page you were on. No, I'm saying if I'm sitting down in a McDonald's.
How are you going to hold your four Whoppers? I don't understand.
And all the toys from no, I would take the, yeah, if I'm sitting in it, I take it off. If I'm maneuvering.
Yeah, but then the fucking air gets in it, like the McDonald's shit air.
Hey, you're eating Snowden. The shit food. I'm not worried about the air.
Dude, fuck
fucking
that.
Hey, Snowden, take it easy. Well,
I'm eating like 15 chicken beaks in my nuggets. I'm not worried about the air.
Hang on, let him do the Snowden joke again.
Yeah, hit it.
Hey, you stepped on it.
I liked it.
Trying to broadcast it.
Bobby's such a fucking, he's kind of like you, where you never know where you're saying. You're like, oh, we're best friends, and then he fucking pulls the rug out from under you.
And he got a straw in your eye.
Yeah, it keeps you on your fucking toes. I like it.
Having a good time, they get hit with a radio.
Yeah. I feel like that guy that you fucking beat up in the park. Oh my God, Bobby's great. No, he ain't. Oh my God. All right, let's see here. Let's run through a couple of more. This is from Walter. Have you ever left something outside to get... I mean, now that you have a house in the burbs, have you ever left something outside to get cleaned off by the rain because you were too lazy to do it yourself?
What the fuck is that?
I don't know, like a lawn... I don't know.
I've left stuff outside, but not to do
not
that.
Just in purpose. No,
wait a minute. Wait.
Who's cutting the grass, by the way? You or you got a guy?
Well, yeah, do you mind? Come on. I do everything in my house. Like, I build stuff. I do the garden with my wife. I do a lot of stuff. I clean the gutters. I'll fucking clean the house, but I don't do the lawn.
Not the maintenance.
No, I don't do that shit. But number one, here's
you're an artist.
No. The guy, when we went in there, I was all prepared to get a lawnmower and all that shit. And the guy doing it, Gaetano, he's like 90, Italian guy. He fucking waddles. He's been doing this place for 30 years. And I didn't want to take the job away from him. So I just was like, and he's fucking murdered two of my lilac bushes. He's taken out fucking tree, like little, like some of our plants. He'll just weed whack shit. We had this grass that is like special grass that we put in the front rock garden. And one of his guys just came over with a weed wagon. And I was like, what are you doing? He goes, trimming the grass. I'm like, that's not grass. But I can't fire him. I can't fire him because he's this old Italian guy. And I just, I feel like he has to be in my life. So what are you going to do?
I respect it. I respect it. I don't hate it.
You're crazy, but I respect it. I love it. It's
great. All right, let's wrap up on this one. This is from Emmett. Did you ever take part in a St. Patrick's Day parade?
Actually, in it, on a float.
Or walking, holding like one of those AOH banners or something.
Some dirtbag youth
kid. I did.
Yeah.
I did. It was in Boston. Me and Al and the Monkees.
Famous Al and the Monkees.
We were.
I know.
Who are they?
It was Al. Oh, I forget troop. Al's last name.
Your comedy troupe.
Al Del Benny.
Al Del Benny.
Dane Cook.
That's right.
Yeah. You and I think that's it. Maybe.
No, Jay Hall.
Jay Hall.
Yeah. We Jay hooked it up.
You guys got booed at the Garden.
We got a fucking
after
hot
like one. Pearl Jam or something, right?
Spin Doctors.
Spin Doctors.
In between Spin Doctors and Fish. they had us
fucking Bobby and the Monkees go out.
They had us go up and do improv. In between those two,
they were
bands.
Like famous. They were like a famous regional.
Really,
for a hot minute. After that, though, things went downhill.
Just a bunch of hippies on acid. Like, are they making all this up?
Oh no, those hippies are violent. I've never had that many fucking flip flops and lighters thrown at my fucking head. In my life. They were violent fucking people, man. But yes, we were in a float. We were in a convertible. Car.
How do you do improv while moving? Somebody give me a job. Name an occupation.
Doing the windshield wipers.
No, I said. I go. I literally said this. I go. Give us three things that you hate besides us. And then a shoe came by my head, and we called it a day. I've never. They went Shana na na. Hey.
Oh,
it was bad. It was fucking bad.
How'd you get into the parade?
Well, that was Jay Hall, who knew somebody in East Boston, got us in this fucking parade.
I imagine
and
that phone
call. I got us a parade.
Yeah,
all our troubles are over. We're in the parade.
It was fucking great, though, because I've always wanted to be in the parade.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
It's
St.
A good
Patty's
time.
Day parade
fun time.
Fucking in Boston?
Well, we weren't in the St. Patty's Day. This was the East Boston little small thing.
Oh, that's garbage. Oh, my God. You're in an off-brand parade?
Just in the back of an El Camino? Who doesn't get the main stage at a parade?
Patty's has one T.
I'm pretty sure the Little League was the behind us as the finale. But yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, we were Mr. Pibb St. Patrick's Day Parade.
Yeah, we were.
He's in the minors.
We were not in the.
Guys, if we do well this year, they said we can play ball next year with them in the big leagues.
All you got to do is walk straight. What's the fucking problem? You're making a left and a right. We're never going to get to the big time.
If you
Jesus Christ.
Get your act together, we're never going to make it to Macy's.
I believe it was 15 minutes, a 20-minute parade.
Yeah.
It was like up a street.
Yeah. And then all right, listen, we're going to start on 2nd Street, go to 3rd Street, and then we're going to hit the bar. All right, go.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was it.
You seen the Italians in a way, you beat them up. That's all you got to do.
No, but it was Italian section. East Boston was all Italian. Oh, so God. It was the Italian version of it. Oh, shit.
Oh, that's fantastic.
But I remember this. I remember
green
this.
Green lasagna. But he's serving.
Green spaghetti and meatballs.
Nobody knew who we were.
No shit.
I remember just little kids looking up going, who's that? Aww. And the mother was like, I don't know. Yeah, like the person that did the parade loved us, but didn't take into account that nobody
those
else
are always
knew
the
us.
Worst gigs ever.
The worst.
Yeah, they're like, oh, I love you. I'm a big fan. And then you're sitting there and it was like, who the fuck invited this guy?
Nobody else knows you. Exactly. Yeah. Those are the worst gigs when one person thinks you're great.
Yeah, the guy booking it's like, I know the best comedian for this.
Yeah, and they bring you in. It's just a bunch of fucking aunts.
That's a tough one.
He's dying laughing in the back. You're bombing everybody else. Oh, man.
I thought you were good. That's always tough. I've gotten that not too long ago, to be honest with you.
You did?
Yeah. Well, I'm so rusty. I was down in Helium with Akash, and somebody's like, I thought you were good. I'm like, ooh.
Everybody else thought you sucked.
Yeah, that's worse than that's worse than you too.
Oh,
you're the best comic ever. Oh, you too.
You too. I got. Yeah. I mean, I think we talked about it on the Patreon, but just to show the levels of comedy, the show's doing well, so people were like, I loved afterwards. Like, I love the fucking podcast. It was so cool. Like, they were like, I was like coming out like, Kippy. I felt famous. I'm like, this is great.
Yeah.
And then I talked to this couple for 10 minutes. I was on top of the world and I walked back into the showroom and some girl goes, can you get me a pen? And I'm like, no, I don't work here. And her husband's like, no, he's one of the comedians. She goes, oh, I know. I'm like, she's like, can you find me a pen? I'm like, God. I'm
it's like, going to be in your neck. I'm going to find it and stab your fucking jugular, you fucking loudmouth asshole.
I was like right back to her. Dude, I walked into the showroom feeling like $1 million, and then this chubby broad asking me for a bic.
Oh, that's fucking assholes. They really just bring it. Fucking twat.
Oh, no, I know. Can you find me a pen? Yeah. Find me. She sent me, gave me a fucking to-do list.
I'm fucking twat.
All right. That's about
what an episode. What a show. Bobby, thank you
so much for coming in.
Yes, thank you, guys.
Anything you want the folks out there to know you got coming up? What?
Well, my dates, robertkellylive.com. You go to robertkellylive.com for all my comedy dates. I'm back on the road for March, April, which I'm very excited about. And then, of course, patreon.com/robertkelly. Mm-hmm. I know you remember this Patreon, but, I'm over there, too, with a bunch of shit. Mm-hmm. So we're all trying to fucking make it happen and keep this shit going. I'm glad it's opening up. And I'm so happy for your success, you two, because I've always liked you.
Thank you.
I mean,
you.
I really love you.
Never wanted nothing really to do with you, but...
Oh, glad, we know.
Oh, we know.
I'm glad you found something.
Thank
you. You know what I mean? I'm glad something clicked.
Thank you.
I mean, right at the buzzer, didn't it?
Oh, my. You have no idea.
Oh, gee, it was like a Celtics-Lakers game. 3-2. You guys both woke up on the floor. Did it work? It went in. Thank God.
Foley's got a half-court career.
Yeah. Foley was about to kill himself in a closet with Twinkies.
That pandemic was coming in like a perfect storm. Hey, you better do something now, boys, if you want to make it through.
Kippy was about to sell fucking real estate.
I was looking to get my Series 6.
He was going
to
get a fucking townhouse in Bensalem, Pennsylvania.
I'm from Bensalem.
I went to school there.
In Bensalem, Pennsylvania.
Next podcast.
Oh, wow.
Jesus.
Holy shit.
Ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, Mr. Robert Kelly. Buddy, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Kippy, what do you got?
Just as always, please make sure you rate, review, subscribe on YouTube, iTunes. It helps us out. We appreciate it. Patreon.com for bonus content and the live show, guys. They're all socially distant. Limited seating, so get your fucking tickets. If we're coming to your town, it'll be a good time. It'll be a little bit of stand-up, a little bit of AYG with you guys. We'll be taking questions. It'll be a good time. Get involved.
It's going to be fun. Get those tickets for Raleigh and for Zanies. ASAP. We love you. We'll see you next week.
Peace.
Hold on there, cowboys and cowgirls. Before you guys step on out of the saloon here, I want to talk to you partners real quick one more time about that good old stereo app. You got Kippy and Uncle Hank there Thursday nights, 9 o'clock, but I got a lot of other good things to know about it.
Yeah, guys, I like this character, baby. It's juicing me up. Guys, if you're not familiar, go check it out. We're there every week. It is a fun time. It's a good way for you to interact with us and the show. And the other people, you get to hear other people's questions. We get a couple hundred people tuning in every time. It's a lot of fun. There's a lot of good shows on there. So check it out. Go to stereo.com/Kevin Ryan or /H Foley. The link will be in the description of the show. Check it out. We'll see you there.
Yeehaw!
Peace!